हेलो
हेलो कैन
हेलो,
यू हियर मी? या
यस
आई
एंड
कैन
हियर
हियर
एको
यू.
एंड हियर
ग्रेट
एको
ग्रेट ग्रेट.
ग्रेट
वेलकमिंग
गाइस,
बोथ ऑफ यू टू बी अ
टू
पार्ट
बी अ
ऑफ
पार्ट
ऑफ
ऑफ
दी
दी
वुमेन्स
स्पेशल
स्पेशल ई टॉक
ई-टॉक
सेशन.
सेशन
एंड टू
एंड
बिगिन
टू
विद
बिगिन
आई
विद
स्टार्ट
आई
विद
स्टार्ट
ब्रीफ
विद ब्रीफ
इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बोथ ऑफ
इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ
यू.
बोथ ऑफ यू.
सो
सो
डॉक्टर
डॉक्टर
अनीता
अनीता
इज अ मेंटल
इज
हेल्थ
अ मेंटल
एक्सपर्ट
हेल्थ एक्सपर्ट
with over
विद
three
ओवर थ्री
decades
थ्री
of
डेकेड्स ऑफ
experience
एक्सपीरियंस
of leading
ऑफ लीडिंग
national and
नेशनल
international
एंड इंटरनेशनल
projects in
प्रोजेक्ट
the space
इन दी
of
स्पेस ऑफ
sexual and
सेक्सुअल एंड
reproductive health.
रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ.
And we have with
एंड वी
us
हैव विद
also
अस ऑल्सो
Archita,
अर्चता
who is the
हु
founder
इज द
of Sri
फाउंडर ऑफ
Nari,
श्री नारी
which is an
विच इज एन
innovative
इनोवेटिव
platform
प्लेटफॉर्म
providing women
प्रोवाइडिंग विमेन
opportunities to grow
opportunities to
and
grow
earn
and earn
and at the
and
same
at the
time
same time
sell their
sell
products.
their product.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So with this
So
I
with this
welcome
I
both of
welcome
you
both of you
to the women
to the women
special session.
session session
And I look forward
and I
to
look
hearing
forward to
both of
hearing
you
both of you
your journey,
your journey,
how you
started
challenges that you
challenges
faced
that you faced
and the
and the
hurdles that you
hurdles
overcome.
that you overcome.
So
officially
so welcoming
officially
both of you
both of you
to be a part
to
of
be
the
a
session.
part of the session.
Thank you
Yeah,
so
thank
much,
you so
Meghna,
much,
and
Meghna, and
wishing both of
wishing
you
both
a
of
very
you
a very
happy
Women's
happy
Day.
Women's Day.
And
And
first thing,
and first
you know,
thing,
I want to
I
say
want to
something
say
again is
something
that
again is
I
that
love what you've
I
done
love
to
what
your
you've done to
faith,
your faith,
and I am
and
very
I am very
curious.
curious.
To know
To
that
know that
you know what you've
you know
written
what
on
you've
your
written on
forehead.
your forehead. So I think
So
it's
I think
it's the
it's the
Instagram
Instagram
account and it
account and
says
it says
I am my
I am
own
my
muse.
own muse.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay,
So
that's really
just
lovely.
one
Just
second,
one
Meghna.
second,
There is
Meghna.
a friend
There is
of
a
mine
friend of mine
who is giving
who
a
is
tip
giving
to
a
us,
tip
saying
to
that
us,
if
saying
we
that
use
if we use
headphones,
headphones,
maybe we will
maybe
not
we will
echo.
not echo. I'm using a
I'm
headphone.
using a headphone.
I'm
also using
okay,
a headphone.
Okay, so maybe
okay,
then
so
it's
maybe
me.
then it's
So you
me.
guys
So you
continue
guys
and let me
continue
try
and let
this,
me
okay?
try this, okay?
Okay,
Yeah.
okay,
okay,
okay.
Thank you, Meghna, for the good introduction and the lovely Women's Day wishes. We wish you a happy Women's Day too, and all the audience that is here with us, a lovely Women's Day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's
so let's
start
let's start
by hearing
by
your
hearing
inspiration
your
journey
journey
of how you
yeah.
started
how
in
you
this
started
field
in this field
and your insights
and your insights
on how can we
how
lead
can
a
we
more
lead
healthy
a
and a
more
balanced
healthy and a
life.
balanced life.
Yeah, I started my journey about 30 years back within the health space, but in the recent times I took out a different trajectory, and in the last 1 year there was a lot of fear and anxiety with related to COVID, and we set up a helpline which was free of cost, and it reached, and the most touching experience was a army man calling our helpline and asking us for services for his wife who was in another small town. So it was really really reassuring to say that how we can make a difference by reaching out mental health services on a platform which is easily accessible to men and women, and they can really reach out and the problems get sorted out by just talking to people, trying to resolve your issues, trying to work out what best solutions that you can work out.
That's
so
wonderful.
That's
wonderful.
wonderful.
Let's hear from
Let's
you,
hear
Archita,
from
your
you,
story.
Your story
of empowering
of
many more women.
Many more women.
Yes. Yes. So I think my, you know, like I've always said, my journey started, you know, from home. I was brought up by a very powerful pack of very empowering women who always believed in, you know, breaking barriers and, you know, not living by norms, and also supported by a powerful family of men who, you know, always were by our side. And you know, like I always say, when you support somebody's dream, you not necessarily have to just hold their hands and lift them up literally, but at least don't push them down, right? And so that is what I was brought up with, those kind of thoughts and inspirations, and I'm taking that forward through Srinari, where I want to build this powerful community of women entrepreneurs through my platform, my e-commerce platform, and you know, I want them to become financially independent. You know, I want them to dream big, build their brand, and you know, and grow leaps and bounds. So I'm trying to build aspirations, and I hope that you know, connections like you all, you know, inspiring women like all of you, you know, join our journey and help us do what we do.
Definitely, that would really inspiring. So, Dr. Neva, you were saying something.
I said, as women, we lift each other up. And that's the message of Women's Day.
Absolutely. And that's so great to hear from you too, ma'am, because I know in times, you know, in your times there was not much of, you know, so today we have social media to, you know, talk about, you know, whatever our ideas are and everything, but women, you know, like yourself have actually been on the field doing what, you know, some people are just talking about today, but, you know, you have actually been the power of all of this.
Yeah, because social connects are so important for women, and when women come as collectives, as people who help each other, a lot can be done, and that's where they empower women. And many a times there are women who slip in the journey, and when women support each other, they are able to lift themselves up and move ahead.
Very true. So, there are two questions which are coming to my mind, which I really want to hear from you. So, because we have a lot of women entrepreneurs to following our page. So, first question is, how can women lead a more balanced and a healthy life? Specifically during the time of pandemic, when we saw that, you know, there was a lot of mental distress. And the second question is, how can we empower women so that they feel more strong about themselves and at the same time fail?
See, a lot of women are brought up in the culture saying that you're very dependent on men for every decision of your life or to some adult in the family. And this whole pandemic has questioned that and made women see themselves as independent individuals by themselves, because the circumstances forced them to relook at themselves, because many of the women may not have been able to really do it at in normal life. And some of the women said, let's do things, because at times in some households probably the men lost their jobs, there were certain things that they lost their jobs. It could also mean that there was a need in the family, they had a lot of time in the family, so there were a lot of questions that came in, and that's when women said that why not we do something on our own. And to respond to it, there were spaces that government also opened up, like you had a lot of women's and entrepreneurship programs happening in the country, and so women started joining them and developing a sense of comfort within that space, learning new things. And if you look at it, women do not have access to knowledge, and this actually gave them the access. The second part is in terms of their own emotional state of mind. And when they saw, it was a synergetic effect, when they saw another woman actually working and moving up the ladder, they also got that strength and they drew a lot of strength from the others. The third part was in terms of they themselves looking at it and looking at themselves, and possibly the whole effect of them, like they probably learned the different ways of doing things by themselves. Till now they were dependent on the men to look at their finances, look at their legal registration process. This gave them an opportunity to put their leg in and then say, why not I walk? And they started that journey of walk, and they also realized that, yes, I can do it. And when they could not do it, they could reach out to other women who became a force to help and be scaffold them. There was a huge scaffolding that happened in the space. And that's where I feel that women have been able to really look at it. And they also got the resources from different points. Like there was somebody they could reach out to for their legal aspect, they could reach to technical aspect, they could reach out for emotional support, they could get the collective effort, they knew how to now put themselves up on the social media. So there's a lot of things that I saw happening within the women, and that's a power that we really see today.
That's very
so true. Absolutely. And you know, like what ma'am said, I also want to add on that, you know, women are born leaders, right? They are all born, we are multitaskers, you know, we are empathic, you know, we know how to, you know, work-life balance, you know, we know how to do that, and we are born leaders. But at some point, you know, because of these patriarchal ideologies, you know, that the society kind of drills but yes, we've always had leaders, you know, coming forward and, you know, entrepreneurs coming forward. And like what ma'am said, I think this pandemic was like a major eye-opener. Right, and right. That is why it is so important for organizations, you know, big or small, to have women leaders, right? Because that helps build aspirations. You see a woman leader. In fact, today I had a small session with a corporate, and I want to share one thing that happened. So I requested everyone to close their eyes and imagine that they were getting into a board meeting, right? And I asked them, once you're in the meeting, who do you visualize starting the meeting, whether it's a male or a female? Most of them, except one person out of the 250 people, one man said, I visualize a woman. Okay? Everyone else said that we visualize men. You know, and that is the truth. You know, and that is something that we need to change. Every organization must make a promise that, you know, we will start every event, because that helps close this gender bias that happens. So, because both of you have been working entirely throughout the pandemic to uplift many more women.
So what were some of the challenges that you observed, and what were the hurdles that you faced and how did you overcome them?
Okay, if you look at it in that sense, there are a lot of women. I would say that in the pandemic, the people who came in on the need base were primarily men and families. It was not specifically women. But at the background of the whole thing, there were women who were trying to manage the resources. They were the ones who were trying to, they were feel, the pinch was felt more by the women, because the men invaded their space into the house, because the men had come home now, and the women did not have the space which was rightfully theirs. They probably saw the men walking out of the house at 9 o'clock in the morning and coming back at 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock in the thing. And there was this woman who felt that her space was occupied by the husband now, because she was not used to it. The husband would say, children should not shout. You should not walk around loud with heavy steps. So the house became almost like a central jail for them, because they couldn't talk, they couldn't whisper, they couldn't do anything. And it took a lot of effort to get back to that man and say that you are occupying the space which was rightfully theirs. And And once they understood this concept that you are the one who have invaded this space, it was much easier for the family to work out a space for them. And this woman today, and she went through a lot of trauma because she is a dancer by profession. And because of pandemic, she couldn't really meet her friends. She couldn't really connect with people. Her classes had to be stopped. And the online classes doesn't give you that energy. And her anxiety was really, really high on those days. And there were marital conflict. There were things like she was just feeling like, I should break away from this guy. I can't handle him anymore. And as the months went by and we were working together, she's now emerged out. Her dance classes have started again. She doesn't call me anymore to say that my anxiety issues are there. I can see her on the social media, putting up pictures of her dance classes, her dance events. So it can there's a lot that can happen to women during the pandemic and post the pandemic, where their freedom is opened up, their choices are in their hands, their ability to move is available for them.
So Meghna, I want to also like you know get hear your you you know but your opinion about this.
So for me, it has been a roller coaster, right? Because I started my operation, my venture Swan, last year in the month of January. And we were primarily working on empowering youth coming from economically weaker sections of the society. And it was during the month of March when everything went into lockdown. We saw firing happening. We saw people losing out on their jobs. And many of them were the contractual frontline workers. We couldn't, withstand the pain, which they were going through. And at the same time, we had started giving a lot of requests from college-going students and also working professionals. So we further took this opportunity to upskill the students who were there with us. Somehow, by digitally connecting them, and at the same time, we expanded our operations online by counseling support and also upskilling workshop support to working professionals and also college-going students.
Lovely.
So it happened very fast. Because we were working in-class training sessions, but we managed somehow, and the sessions went well, and we also started getting connected to a lot of like-minded people, through which we further initiated the Sunday learning circle.
Nice.
So that's how the journey has been so far. It's about your resilience of being an entrepreneur.
Like a lot of women are basically resilient. They can take challenges in a very smooth way. In that sense, they find creative ways. They find new ways to deal with the context and find solutions to their problem. And that's, I think, where the strength of women is. And we need to challenge today with the theme that choose to challenge the set myths that we hold against women, that women cannot handle things. Women can handle things and are able to do it. And they probably do it better because every day of their lives, they had been doing it.
Absolutely. Very true.
So that's when I say they're born entrepreneurs, they're born leaders. Because all the qualities that you mentioned, ma'am, are all the qualities of an entrepreneur. Right? And women are doing that without knowing that they're so amazing at it. you know, like, and I sometimes say that, you know, today there are marketing, you know, lingos, marketing language that says that, you know, a mystery shopper or, you know, word of mouth. But on and who are these mystery shoppers and who are these people who are spreading the word, right? And most of them are women. There are women influencers. There are women bloggers. The percentage is higher. And then the society on the other side also sometimes says, "Oh, women talk too much." You know, but you know that is what marketing is, and that is what is helping you and your brand build.
Very true. And I seriously wish that. That we had more number of women investors as well.
Yes, absolutely.
So that, you know, it was very easy for us to put forward our idea across and through them.
Yes, as a startup, I'm facing that. And in fact, if there is a, you know, a room full of investors whom I'm talking with, you know, there's probably one woman. Okay, and you know, the belief that they have on a woman based startup, although it is brilliant on papers, okay, on written, you know, supporting you know, women entrepreneurs come up, especially during this pandemic, but in reality, there is a dearth of it.
Very
right.
True.
And
very
through true. Shrinari, that is one of the things that, you know, I also want to build, that I want to build this powerful community, you know, of women entrepreneurs and for women, right? So that somebody is sitting in Kerala is, you know, supported by somebody sitting in Delhi, you know, or somebody sitting in Kolkata, you know, and so that is the network I'm trying to build, so that at the end of the day, we can all uplift each other and we can all support each other.
Very true, very true. And that's, I think, a very noble cause that you have taken up by supporting a lot of women entrepreneurs who really face difficulty in, you know, selling their products. Because during the pandemic, all of us observed that, you know, the shops and the stores got closed.
Right.
So, yeah, that's a wonderful initiative. So, over to you, Dr. Anita. Would you like to share your insights on maternal health and also how can women take care of themselves?
Yeah, see, most of the entrepreneurs, if you look at it, start their journey either at around the age of 20 to 35 or 40. And that's also the phase when women go into motherhood. And right. During the motherhood, the woman is now into a new family. Generally, if you look at it, you're married at around 20, 22, around that age. You walk into a new family, which is not your, in the sense, you're a new entrant to that. And you're just trying to make adjustments to this new family. And then at that time, you become pregnant. So before you have settled into your own space, you have now into a new role of being a mother. And there's a lot of conflict that happens at that time. And a lot of things in terms of the woman is now has to suddenly become an adult who has to take care of another person. And there's somebody, another new life growing within her. And that can cause a lot of stress and tension. In addition to that, pregnancy itself also plays a lot on our hormones. And combine these two, your interpersonal space within your household and the hormones can actually create riots in a woman's body. And there's a likelihood of many women feeling very anxious, very depressed, and feeling that what is it, I really can't go through this journey. I can't take this transition that I'm supposed to take. And that's when they are not very comfortable in their own skin. However, within the household, there is a whole pressure that this is an interpersonal issue which has to be handled within the house. But the fact is that it is not only social. It has also got a sort of a biological piece also because of the disturbances in the hormones. And so that is when working only, taking a decision that I will work within my house and this story should not come out, really doesn't work in the benefit of women. They need to seek services, they need to talk to somebody. If need be, if they need medication, then you will have to consider what is the best medication that these women can be given. And a lot of it may not be necessarily medication, but it's more in terms of restructuring your role transition, restructuring your own space, getting over your guilt feeling, getting over the whole thing of what are the skill sets I don't have, and being comfortable within my skin. And those are the things that can be worked out in a therapeutic relationship. And that's the journey I am taking today in terms of helping women to make this transition much more smoother and easier during this period of pregnancy and post-delivery. And this keeps continuing. It's a journey because it might happen up to the age of the child is 3 years. And it is like, I was talking to one of the women who's an entrepreneur. She said, I went through this journey for 18 months. Something could have been sorted out within a month. See the amount of agony that women go through.
Yes.
All because they do not seek services. And it's extremely, extremely important that women break this whole glass ceiling and come out and take services, reach out. The families need to be really working and saying that, okay, this is our child. The child should not be disadvantaged. The woman should not be disadvantaged. Go out and seek the services that you really require. There's no stigma in it. You're not a failure if you take services. You're rather an empowered woman if you have reached out to a service. You will live a life which is much better, and your child will grow much, much more healthier, much, much more emotionally secure. An insecure environment does not bring a child up in feeling secure about themselves. And that's a message I want to give to women on International Women's Day.
That's lovely. So over to you, Archita. We would really like to know, because we have a lot of women entrepreneurs on our page. So how, if they want to sell their product, how can Srinari help them out in doing so?
So, Srinari, at Srinari.com, the first thing I want women to know is that we not only want you to sell your product, but we want you to build a brand. And the whole idea of, you know, starting something exclusively for women entrepreneurs, for their small businesses, was because even if they're on an e-commerce platform, you know, they're lost in this whole ocean of brands. You know, so you know, we wanted to give them a space, you know, where they are recognized, they are guided through the way. So once you become a part of the Srinari family, we not only guide you on how to upload your products, on how to price your products, you know, but we guide you on how to market yourself as a brand. We help market you as a brand. In fact, we have something called Do Din Dhamaka, for example, where we give two exclusive days to every woman's brand, and we, you know, do paid promotion, social media promotion, just for their brand, right? And
that's wonderful.
E-commerce platforms.
These are all paid services.
So, you know, so this is how we are helping women. Yes, there is a subscription fee to join Srinari, but that's the only fee that you will pay for the entire year. And we give discounts from our side to, you know, help them increase their business. And this kind of discounts they will not be able to get from any platform that, you know, they are selling on. And so I would just request, you know, any woman listening to this is that, call us. You know what Srinari does for you, or will do for you, and then you can decide whether you want to join or not. We are never going to force you to do that. But for me, helping or empowering another woman is very important. Today there are some people who even have their own website. Some women who sell with us, and we are helping them market that. right? So it's not about always competing with each other. Let's collaborate with each other, which is the most important. And that is how you grow, right? So like also one of the points that ma'am said is that, you know, you have to first change internally. Accept that there is something that needs to be changed. And, you know, ignore the stigmas that, you know, the society tells you. And that's when you can come forward and, you know, grow.
Very true. So, that was lovely hearing both of you. And I see a lot of energy that's coming up out of the discussion and also synergy. So, before we come to a closure to the entire discussion, I would want you to share your message to the female entrepreneurs, the student, to the youth, to the facilitators who are there on our page, and who will be watching this video. Yeah. So over to you. Your message, your inspiration to everyone.
Yeah, my message is that be confident about yourself, believe in yourself and your potential, and work on yourself to really get to the potential. The second part is that you work best when you are in contact with people. So don't hesitate to network, be in connect with people and try to get whatever resources you want without hesitation. There's nothing that can happen if you go and ask for help. The world doesn't collapse if the person does not give you help. There's another person out there to help you out. So these are the two things if women believe in, they will be able to be half the sky which they are and make a difference in that space.
Wow. Very true. Very true.
So and, I would and just like would to add on to that and, you know, say that, you know, life was never meant to be easy. Right? And life is full of trials, triumphs, you know, falls, and so many things. But you know, but that doesn't mean that you sit back, right? And just stay where you are. You know, you need to reach out, you need to stand out, and you need to get out in that world. No, I think one thing that everyone, men, women, young girls, everyone have to know that, you know, you have to be afraid of taking risks. Right? But you have to be even more scared of staying put in the place where you are, and if that makes you unhappy. So I wish for every girl out there, every woman out there, is that, you know, be yourself. Do not fall into this, you know, societal standards of perfect. Right? Be raw. You know, be real. And, you know, become, like ma'am said, be comfortable in your own skin. Knowing is the best form of healing. Knowing yourself is the best form of healing, you know. So just be just you. And move forward.
That was super inspiration from both of you. And I really enjoyed all the entire discussion. And it was lovely to have both of you over here. A very happy Timothy once again to both of you.
Thank you so much.
And we would love to invite you to many more sessions going forth which we are planning, some panel discussions that we are planning to hold.
Absolutely. And congratulations on the work that you're doing.
Thank you.
You've taken a wonderful journey of getting people to talk and giving them the platform to talk. And that's actually a space where you bring about the synergy among women and help them to work together as a force that can make a difference.
Absolutely.
Sure. Definitely. Thank you so much once again for being there. And we would look forward to have you, both of you in on our upcoming e-talk session. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Our pleasure. Bye-bye. See you. Bye.